When people expect the end of democracy, when the opposing party wins, that has civil war written all over it. So the generation coming up does not understand the U.S. Constitution, the principles therein. The blue states were like, you know, we want to legalize abortion till up till birth or after birth abortions. Diabolical, I know. What are the common values in this country? Hey guys, today's video looks at the indicators socially, politically, historically of whether we should expect civil war in America. Spoiler alert, yes. Watch the full seminar, of course, at beltoftruth.tv. Martin Armstrong, one of the best, if not the best, cycles forecasters in the world. His computer forecast many years ahead, decades ago, that 2016 would be the rise of an insurgency presidential candidate akin to a third party. In other words, a party realignment just so happened to carry Republican name with it. Here's what he says is on schedule next in the context of this seventh party realignment that his computer foresaw. It's now indicating that the 2024 election will not be accepted by either side, and that it may be the last presidential election in American history. The 2028 election, he said, may not happen. And I don't even count on that we have that many years before Christ returns. I never count long seasons of life before things wrap up here. He says also, the computer is indicating civil unrest rises into 2025. And that can also be related to and connected to the fact that people don't accept the election as legitimate. Here's an interesting thing about how these two view each other. The polarization, we'll come back to Armstrong in a minute, but the polarization and the division in America, this is incredible. By 2020, only 10% of poll respondents in America disagreed with this statement. The Republicans will bring dictatorship, or for the opposing party, the Democrats will bring socialism. Only 10% of Americans disagreed with that drastic of a statement. And I'm not saying these are true or untrue. I'm just saying when people expect the end of democracy, when the opposing party wins, that has civil war written all over it. We're going to talk about civil war at great length in the coming moments here, but this authoritarianism, dictatorship, socialism may actually be brewing. Those under 30 who've apparently never attended a civics class are 2.5 times more likely to favor unitary action by a strong leader over congressional procedure per the U.S. Constitution than those over 60. So the generation coming up does not understand the U.S. Constitution, the principles therein. Another sentiment: democracy is not essential when the nation faces an emergency, also ranks higher than ever among those under 40. So do you hear the harbingers of authoritarianism coming here? Every principle of our once free republic being repudiated. A house divided, America cannot stand if it is a house divided. This polarization is so pronounced that in day-to-day encounters that in polls, what kind of encounters do you really want to avoid at all costs? Like, avoid that kind of person. I know these are not nice things. I wouldn't want to have these thoughts toward anybody. But when people are honest in polls, like, I do not want to be around that kind of person there. Where is the hate directed most of all right now? It's not socioeconomic class. It's not religion. It's not predominantly race. It's political ideology. The people of that viewpoint, I can't be around them. I wish to avoid that more strongly than I wish to avoid any other kind of person. We should look at people as individuals, should we not? Who were bought by the precious blood of Jesus Christ, who are worthy of our love, our sacrifice, our presenting of the gospel, our service. But here you have it, where there begins now geographic sorting by neighborhood, by region of the country, by state of the country. Let's take states. And what do I mean by geographic sorting? You got red states and blue states, and you have blue people in red states leaving to be with their like-minded people in great numbers, and vice versa. The red people, the Republican-minded people, leaving the blue states to be amongst their like-minded people. And this is happening where states are even advertising themselves as havens from the other kind of states, like, you know, escape California and come to Idaho.
Idaho or whatever. Their chambers of commerce are advertising these things, and the states are. So if you think about this, Roe versus Wade used to nationalize legalized abortion. And when Roe versus Wade was overturned, now states can have their own say on it, right? So the red states are becoming redder in that respect. The blue states were like, you know, we want to legalize abortion till up till birth or after birth abortions. Diabolical, I know. But you have all, now the red states saying we're going to protect life. We're going to protect life up till after a heartbeat, or even down to conception in some cases. So becoming stronger and stronger in the pro-life stance. So how about things like LGBT and kids? Geographic sorting, state and neighborhood sorting. You don't want your kids exposed to that. So people are like, we're out of there. Foreign nationals voting in elections in some places. This is unheard of. That's revolutionary level stuff. That's got civil war written all over it. So you might ask this question also. What are the common values in this country? Once upon a time, you might say, in a pluralistic society, people from different religious viewpoints with different beliefs about whatever, that freedom of speech is a common value. Mutual tolerance. Well, that's history, because now you have cancel culture. You don't have freedom of speech because an ideology that says we must stamp out hate thoughts, hate speech, that trumps the freedom of speech itself. So is there, we're one nation, right? One nation under God. But I'm not sure that in the estimation of the broader society, we are one nation under anything anymore. It's almost as if there are two completely distinct and opposing societies existing within the same geographic region, country, nations once called. And they're just like awkwardly yoked under the same national government. But this can't last like this with this trajectory. If something were to be dramatically reversed and we went the other direction and found that polarization reducing, then of course it would maintain its national unity. But another civil war in America, says a scholarly national security studies. I actually studied in the national security studies program, the master's program at Cal State San Bernardino, where one of these authors is a professor. And I looked at their Another Civil War in America, comparing the social psychology of the United States of the 1850s to today. So it's not speculation and hype to say civil war may be coming. We're going to see Hollywood is signaling that.